My name is Erica McCustra, and I'm the brewmaster here at Steamwhistle Brewing. Here at Steamwhistle, we make several different types of beers. We've got our Pilsner, which is 5%, very classic European style, crisp, balanced beer. We've got our Pale Ale, which is, we like to call it a Canadian style Pale Ale, a little bit more hoppy. We've also got our Session Lager, 4%. Very crisp and clean, a great everyday drinking beer. We use only 4 ingredients for producing all of our Steamwhistle brand beers. That's malted barley, hops, spring water, and yeast. We also have a partnership with New Belgium Brewery, and so we make 2 of their beers for them for the Canadian market. That's Fat Tire Amber Ale and Voodoo Ranger IPA. The first step that we take to brew our beer is milling the malt. Then we'll brew the beer in the brew house. Then we'll ferment it, we'll age it, filter it, and finally package it. So in the brew house, we'll take the malted barley and we'll first mill it. So we're crushing it down, and then we're gonna mash it, which is adding water to it, making a porridge-like substance. By adding water to it, we're waking up the enzymes that are in there. They'll start to go to work to degrade some of the components of the malt, such as the proteins and the starches. The really important part of what we're doing in the brew house is converting the starches into sugars that the yeast can ferment. At Steamwhistle, we use decoction mashing, which is a traditionally European form of brewing. Where you will take a portion of your mash, which is your malted barley and your water, you'll boil it, and then you'll return it to the main mash as a way to increase the temperature. The temperature that you hit during your mashing is really important in the final body and alcohol content of the beer. I think that there's a depth of malt character that you can achieve through decoction brewing that isn't achieved through other methods. After mashing, we'll do lautering. So that's a separation of the liquid and the solids. The solids that you got left over is your spent grain. That's going to go out as animal feed, whereas the liquid that you've collected is the wort, and that's going to be boiled. We'll add hops to it. There's a few different steps of when you add hops to your boiled wort. That will impart various properties of the hops, such as bitterness, aroma, or flavor contributions on the final beer. And after boiling, we'll whirlpool it. So we'll allow some of those hops to settle out. We'll take the clarified wort, we'll cool it down, and then we'll transfer it over to the cellar and add yeast. So in the cellar is really where a lot of the magic is happening. Once we add the yeast into the cooled wort in the cellar, it's going to start fermentation, and the fermentation is the process of converting the sugars into alcohol and carbon dioxide. So the yeast is growing, it's fermenting, and once it's produced all of the alcohol and there's no sugars left for it to produce, for it to eat, then it will fall out of suspension. We'll be able to remove that yeast and then reuse it for several generations on the next batch of beer. At that point, once we've removed the yeast, the beer is going to age. And depending on the recipe, that could be anywhere from a week up to 3 weeks or longer. For our Pilsner, the whole process is about 4 weeks from brew house to the end of its maturation time in the tank, whereas for our ales, it's a little bit shorter. We can turn them around in 2 to 3 weeks' time. One really important part of what happens in the cellar is the natural carbonation of our Steamwhistle Pilsner. During fermentation, CO2 is produced naturally by the yeast, and we'll harness the CO2 and keep it in the beer throughout our process, rather than injecting CO2 later in the process. We find this natural carbonation has a really nice sensation to it and gives a nice creamy mouthfeel to the beer. It's a really important part of our Steamwhistle Pilsner. So once the aging process is done, where all the flavors are really marrying together, then we will be ready to filter the beer, and that's just to provide a clarity to the final product. It goes through several stages of filtration before packaging. There's a very small difference in different packaging formats. Our job in the brewery is really to make that difference as small as possible so that the product is consistent across all the packaging formats. One of the biggest things that we're trying to avoid is any oxygen pickup, which will really reduce the shelf life of the beer. So for example, whereas a bottle has a small opening at the top between the bottle and the cap, a can has a little bit of a larger opening between the can and the top of the can. So when you're filling those packaging formats, there's just more surface area on your can and more chance for oxygen to get into the beer. So our main job is really to eliminate the possibility of oxygen getting in, and working with really good equipment and constantly checking and calibrating that equipment is really key to upholding the quality in all the packaging formats. So that's how we make beer here at Steamwhistle Brewing. That being said, we're always trying to improve our products and look at new methods and look at new ingredients that could help make our beer even better. It's always exciting to visit other breweries where they've got different methods, different philosophies, and different equipment that they're working on, learn about their challenges and learn about their successes, and just share information so that we can help make everybody's beer better.